we want to use long division to find the quotient. We have a two-digit number divided by a one-digit number. For this example, instead of using the traditional long division algorithm though, we use a method called partial quotients. The first step is to write the quotient in long division form, which is this form here. These two division problems are equivalent, where A is the dividend, B is the divisor, and C is the quotient. So we'll write 76 divided by 4 as 76 divided by 4 in this form here. And for the partial quotients method, we'll draw a vertical line to the right of our problem here. We'll record the partial quotients on the right. Before we begin though, because the divisor is 4, it'll be helpful to list some products involving 4 that we can easily determine. For example, we know that 1 times 4 equals 4, 2 times 4 equals 8, 3 times 4 equals 12. Of course, we can continue. Let's just list two more. Let's list 5 times 4 equals 20, and 10 times 4 equals 40. Now, going back over to our division problem, for the partial quotients method, we begin by considering the entire dividend of 76. We want to determine a certain number of 4s that we know for sure are in 76. So looking back at our products, because 10 times 4 equals 40, and 40 is less than 76, we know there are at least 10 4s in 76, so we'll use 10 as our first partial quotient. So we'll place a 10 on the right here. Now we multiply by the divisor. 10 times 4 is equal to 40. So we place the 40 below the 76, and now we subtract. 76 minus 40 is equal to 36. Now we repeat the process. We want to determine a certain number of 4s that we know for sure are in 36. Let's just say we don't remember that 9 times 4 equals 36. Looking at our products here on the right, let's say we want to use the fact that we know that 5 times 4 equals 20. Because 20 is less than 36, we know there's at least 5 4s in 36. So 5 will be our next partial quotient. So we place a 5 on the right, multiply by the divisor, 5 times 4 is equal to 20. Place a 20 below the 36, and again we subtract. 36 minus 20 is equal to 16. And again, we repeat the process. We want to determine a certain number of 4s that we know are in 16. And again, let's just say we didn't remember that 4 times 4 is equal to 16, but we did remember that 3 times 4 is equal to 12. Because 12 is less than 16, we know there's at least 3 4s in 16. Let's use 3 as our next partial quotient. So place a 3 on the right. 3 times 4 is equal to 12. Place the 12 below the 16 and subtract. 16 minus 12 is equal to 4. We repeat the process. Because this difference is 4 and so is the divisor, we can easily recognize there's 1, 4, and 4, so 1 is our last partial quotient. 1 times 4 equals 4. Once again, we subtract. In this case, the difference is 0, so our remainder is 0. Now we want to sum the partial quotients on the right. 10 plus 5 plus 3 plus 1 equals 19, which means our quotient is 19 and we don't have a remainder, and therefore 4 is a factor of 76. So the nice thing about the partial quotients method is that we can use any partial quotients that we can find based upon what we know about products involving the divisor, or in this case, products involving 4. So there are many ways to come up with this quotient, because we don't have to use these partial quotients. It's also true that because 76 divided by 4 equals 19, 19 times 4 equals 76. 19 copies or 19 groups of 4 is equal to 76. I hope you found this helpful.